Hi, I'm Henry of bluehairarts.com. Now I'm going to show you the process of design a name chart for a customer, Nikolaj, in Russia. Nikolaj has some Chinese language background. He has a Chinese name chosen by his teacher. The last name his teacher picked is from this syllable po or bo. I'm not sure what the pronunciation in Russian, but anyway, the Chinese reads bo, meaning wave. Is a family name, and his teacher told him to choose from a frequently used name list for his name. So he picked these two characters, Kaiming. So Bo Kaiming. As you know, the Chinese feminine name has about 100 characters. You cannot use any characters for feminine or given name. But for first name, you can use any character. However, there are some letters or characters are used more frequently in the names, and some are rarely used. So you have to check a website, some website online. I'll give you the link if you want to try. And the best is to seeking help from a native Chinese speaker. If you order the name seal from me, of course I will provide service of translation. So after I got this commission, I did these two designs based on ancient seal scripts. And I used some characters from ancient seals, and I modified myself to fit in this nature-shaped stone. There are two options I gave to Nicholas, and he picked this positive style, yang. So I then made a exact copy, exact size as the stone, and I transferred it onto the stone with this special liquid called acetone. It's a nail polish remover you can find in a nail polish remover. Then I got a mirror image on the stone, so I use a flipped image as a reference, so you can see. I use a small knife to trace the detailed part. This first character, bo or wei, it's very sophisticated. And you can see some blurry happened in the transfer. So I need to know the stroke. Even you have this design, you have to adjust according to the situation. This stone is a Changhua stone. Compared with Qingping, it's very kind of harder than Qingping, and you can see there's more powder, not chipping. When the stone is hard, it kind of cut, push downward. Like that. And You can use a bigger knife, carve the background out. This is called positive carving, so you leave the strokes red on the seal. You don't have to cut really deep, but it should be deep enough. This is like a little hand vertical. Very intricate work. This part, I kind of break the edge on purpose. So just break that. You have to understand the structure of the characters, so some part can be merged but not affect reading, or even broken. But some part you have to keep it. This is the water radical. cutting movement again. There's a connection there on purpose to simulate the old seal. Or just kind of like the random effect on stamp or impression, but you can make it as a special effect. So every time it will appear, you make an imprint. Everything is created in a way like it happened on an antique seal. It's natural erosion or broken, sometimes missing lines. There's a rhythm in the line, the width, and the just like writing with a knife. Thank you. Okay. Now I have polished and cleaned up. Let me do a first imprint. I put some rubber mat underneath it. You can use a magazine if you like. Okay. It's pretty close, and just a few dots I need to take out. Okay, now I'm going to make a second imprint. Okay, now it's very clean. I like the natural calligraphic look. Like the pause and the last in front in some of the lines, and overall balance of dense and sparse. In composition of seal design, we have a phrase, a saying says the dense part should not have any room for a needle, and the sparse part you can run a horse. That's, you know, the contrast, talking about the contrast between dense and sparse, density and sparsity. This seal is a good example. So not just even, but create some contrast between the negative space and the solids. Okay, now I'm going to do the official seal impression on my collection book, and you can see these are the previous works I did recently. I like the grainy look on the rice paper also. If you want a more solid, you can blow some moisture from your mouth. That will help. This is a copy for the cunt. See, more solid. Okay, I'd like to thank Nicholas in Russia for your commission of doing this name chop, and thank everybody on YouTube for watching. And please contact me if you want to carve a name seal or mood seal. Thank you. Goodbye.